Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the editorial, and the editorial is on NK Singh committee's recommendation about fiscal responsibility and budget management. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all we need to understand what is meant by fiscal responsibility. Now, before we understand the meaning of fiscal responsibility, we need to understand the requirement of fiscal responsibility. Now, what is the requirement of fiscal responsibility? Now, fiscal responsibility means that the government spends its money, government does spending more prudently. Now, what is the requirement of prudent spending by the government? The government, it needs to spend amount in a prudent manner, because government has finite resources. Now, because government has finite resources and it really needs to do a lot, because the demands of the economy are huge, and the demands of the people are huge, and the requirements to catapult Indian economy to the stage of development is huge. Now, all these things require that the spending by the government should be done more. More of the spending should be done by the government. But as far as the capacity and the capability of the government is concerned to spend more, it is always constrained by what are the revenues of the government. So every government must keep into consideration what is its revenue, and it's only on the basis of revenue decides about expenditure. Now, if the governments will be doing more of expenditure, it will be creating a situation whereby governments will be becoming weak, economically and financially weak. Now, if the governments will be becoming weak, in that case, the investors from the foreign countries, they will not be investing in our country. So this was the reason why government had come out with this FRBM Act, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, in year 2004. But when it comes to the targets, that the government had stipulated, then when this FRBM came into being, now all these targets, they were not looked on. They were disregarded. They were disregarded in year 2008. So whatever standards were proposed in 2004 as per FRBM Act, they were not taken into consideration in 2008. Now, why this disregard about the standards of the FRBM Act? Why this disregarding was done? Where the standard and the target was disregarded. This was disregarded because in year 2008, there was a global economic crisis, GEC. Now, it was because of this global economic crisis, government had to give a fiscal push to the economy. The private sector had begun to flounder. Private sector had begun to wither. So in order to strengthen the economy, in order to give a push to the economy, this was one thing that was really required. The requirement of giving push to the economy. So the fiscal targets of our economy that we had stipulated in 2004 under FRBM Act, they were not taken into consideration. There was a complete disregard about these targets. Now, government had set up this committee, NK Singh committee. Now, this NK Singh committee had put forward the recommendations 2 months back. Now, this has put forward the recommendations in which it had emphasized on few critical aspects. Now, the first critical aspect is taking away the discretion from the government. Now, the governments, they have a tendency to spend more, because of the political pressures, because of the real political scenario, because of the populistic measures that they tend to introduce. So this is one of the reasons why more of spending is done by the governments. Now this discretion should be taken care of according to NK Singh committee by instituting fiscal council. Now this is very, very important. Now the fiscal council should be working independently from the government. It should not have any political influence. It is the fiscal council that should be deciding as per the fiscal ethics that what is the right limit of the spending by the government. Now this is one thing that should be taken care of. So this discretion should be done away with that the current governments they have about spending more by instituting this fiscal council, new fiscal council. Now the second important thing this NK Singh committee has talked about is instituting exception clause. Exception clause. There might emerge a situation whereby our country has to face certain challenges because of climatic change, certain challenges because of war, certain challenges because of some drought kind of thing. So in such kind of scenarios, the government will require to spend more. Now because the government will require to spend more, now all these things, exceptions means exceptions during which the government should be spending more and can deviate from the path that will be set up by this fiscal committee. Now NK Singh committee has also suggested another important thing, that apart from focusing on revenue deficit and fiscal deficit, government should be also focusing on to reduce debt to GDP ratio. कि debt to GDP ratio को क्या करो आप, कम करो, इस चीज को reduce करो. Now presently हमारा debt to GDP ratio क्या है, it is in the range of 68% and it needs to be reduced to 60%. So this is what this NK Singh committee has recommended. Don't focus on fiscal deficit and revenue deficit alone, though they should be reduced and they should be brought to the limit of 3% of the GDP. But there might also emerge certain exception situations in which the government may have to deviate from following a prudent fiscal path. So in that scenario, NK Singh committee had suggested for this exception clause, and it had also suggested for this discretion and how to curtail this discretion, and it had also suggested for to focus on this aspect, this index, that is of debt to GDP ratio. It should be reduced to 60%. Now for the center, it is focused that it should be 40%, and for the state it should be 20%. But it is fallacy of this NK Singh committee to give this recommendation of reducing the fiscal debt to GDP ratio of the states to 20%. Uniformity. He has asked for that all the states should be focusing on to achieve this limit of debt to GDP, but this is actually not possible because all the states are not uniform in terms of the GDP, their GDP strength. They are not same in terms of the revenue they are generating. They are not same in terms of the expenditure they will require to incur. So from examination point of view, a question can be asked critically, analyze the recommendations of NK Singh committee. Now you can write answer on this and you can WhatsApp me your answers. I will evaluate your answer and give you a feedback on the answers. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.